Please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Welcome to Money, 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 your weekly personal finance date with me, Surabhi Upadhyay. Now, the Supreme Court has made it mandatory for four-wheelers and two-wheelers to have multi-year insurance from the 1st of September. So, if you are going to buy a car after the 1st, you will need to have three-year third-party motor insurance cover. Those buying a bike, similarly, will have to buy a third-party motor cover for 5 years instead of the usual one-year policies that we end up having. So how will this order be implemented? What does it mean for both the policy buyer as well as insurers? Well, we will find out over the course of the next half an hour. My guests on the show are Rakesh Jain from Reliance General Insurance, Puneet Sahani of SBI General Insurance, and Divya Gandhi, who heads insurance at MK. Well, we'll be with the lady and the gentleman in just a bit. Before we get started, let's go over to my colleague Yash Jain to understand the key points of this important Supreme Court order.
Well, Surabhi, July 20th was the date when the Supreme Court asked the insurance regulator IRDA to ensure availability of longer tenure motor third-party insurance policies starting September 1st. Now, essentially, the tenure of these longer motor third-party policies was increased to 3 years and 5 years for private cars and two-wheelers from the current one-year each. And as things stand, 10 days before the order actually comes into force. But there is a fair bit of confusion and uncertainty as far as the rollout of this new product is concerned. Why do I say that? The industry sources I've been talking to tell me that the GI Council, which is the General Insurance Council, has reached out to IRDA asking the regulator to approach the Supreme Court to get some more time extension as far as the September 1 deadline is concerned. Also, what we're given to understand is that the GI Council has expressed concerns with respect to lack of clarity when it comes to regulations from IRDA's end on the longer tenure motor third-party insurance policies. I've been speaking to IRDA also on the same matter, and my sources there tell me that the IRDA is not going to approach Supreme Court in any situation, but they've said that if the GI Council wants any sort of time extension, they can approach Supreme Court in their own capacity. Also, as far as the regulations are concerned, IRDA plans to come out with more clarity on these regulations around longer-term motor policies by August 25th. In the same conversation which I had with my sources at IRDA, I've been able to get some more information in terms of what these regulations could really look like. So as far as the pricing element is concerned, no discount or no premium is expected from IRDA's end. So essentially, the three-year policy for cars, that could be priced at three times the current one-year motor TP cost. Also, for two-wheelers, which is the five-year policy for two-wheelers, that could be priced at five times the current one-year cost, which is the motor third-party premium. As far as the commission element is concerned, that for insurance brokers could be lowered from the current 2.5%. One more thing which I've been picking up is that IRDA might mandate vehicle buyers to buy both elements of motor policy, which is the comprehensive policy as well as the motor third-party policy, from the same insurance company, simply from the point of view of smoothening the entire claim settlement process when it comes to these insurance companies.
All right, Yash, thanks very much. So lots of points over there and lots of unanswered questions as well as we get to the 1st of September. So let's take this one by one. Now, as we mentioned, Rakesh Jain, Puneet Sahani and Divya Gandhi are with us. Let me first start with you, Rakesh. We'll come to the implementation in just a bit. But first thoughts, overarching order from the apex court. How do you read it?
Thanks for having me on the show. Unfortunately, I'm not there. But you see, I think from a concept point of view, this order is well placed. The court means very clearly that, you know, third-party liability product is mandatory for every vehicle to be on the road. So this is not a discretionary insurance which a customer can buy. And if you read the court order, it clearly says that today one out of three vehicles running on the road just has insurance. Two out of three are uninsured. And this obviously poses a lot of risk to all the people who are, you know, in this society. And whenever some accident happens, the first thing people want to just check is do the vehicle have an insurance policy or not, and hence whether a claimant will be able to get a claim or not. So I think looking at this, there is hardly any dispute in terms of, you know, saying that the order is well placed and this needs to be enforced. And in the long run, I think it is good for everybody, including the insurance companies.
Okay. Let me put that same question to Puneet Sahani from SBI General. Puneet, your own interpretation of moving from a, you know, annual sort of policy buying system to one that's going to be 3 years for cars and 5 years for motorbikes.
As the Supreme Court has seen and has quoted in their order that many vehicles on road are without insurance, without even the mandatory insurance. This is a good step in the sense that people will have less hassle of renewing it every year. I will have a chance of 3 year and a 5 year renewal, and the insurance companies will also gain in the sense that the more number of people would get insured. So insurance is basically law of large numbers, so it will start playing around that. So more and more people will come into the fold of insurance, and hence the insurance kitty on that particular line of business will grow. So it will help insurers to try and get losses around being settled.
Okay. Well, that's in principle. So in principle, insurers are also agreeing that it's probably a good thing both for the customer and for the industry. But Rakesh, let me now come to some of the unanswered questions, because what we don't know is, I believe that at least for two-wheelers, there are still multi-year policies which you can still buy in the market. But what about cars? And then it's the question that this order applies to, I believe, only third-party motor insurance. So what happens? Because right now, typically when we go and buy a car, you get a comprehensive insurance cover. I mean, you pay anything between 5,000 to 10,000, depending on your vehicle. What should we expect from the 1st of September?
This will be first and foremost, motor is the most dominant product in this market. It really constitutes almost 40% of the insurance premium. In terms of customer base, this is also the largest, in terms of volumes. And this gets sold across the length and breadth of this country. So structurally, this calls for a thought out change. It is not something which is a new product, which sometimes you can always stage it and promote. So I think the most important things which we are looking at is, traditionally, this has been a 1 year product. Till a couple of years back, when as an experiment, we went towards a 3 year two wheeler. And I think that experiment has emerged well, because quite a few people have opted for that. But it was an optional cover, so we really cannot compare the present court order with that three-year thing, because in options, people obviously get discretionary. From a customer point of view, there has always been, if you buy a three-year, that means you are committing to pay the premium upfront for 3 years, which means it's a bit like your cost of buying the vehicle may go up a bit. But if you see from a convenience point of view, if you see from compliance point of view, it is actually a far wiser thing to do. So I feel that, structurally, this will be a good thing to happen. But conceptually, a few things on TP, which is the only mandatory cover, and hence the Supreme Court has only asked for that portion. The OD is a discretionary cover, and frankly, we need to really figure this out, whether OD also needs to come in the long-term format or not.
Okay.
And as a discretionary insurance, you really cannot ask the customers to mandatorily buy an OD for 3 years.
Oh, yes, absolutely. OD being, of course, own damage, and TP being third-party damage. Rakesh, stay on. Let me also bring in Divya Gandhi into the conversation. So, Divya, there are lots of moving parts right now.
Right.
We don't know how these products will actually look like,
right,
whether the payment is going to be upfront immediately or how it works. But your understanding of the order and the way you're looking at it?
For quite some time, I think there have been gaps in this renewal of third-party insurances. And as you've seen numbers, a lot of vehicles run today also on the roads without the third-party mandatory cover.
Apparently, the numbers are as high, and I was looking at some statistics,
yes,
as high as 66%
of
the vehicles on India's roads don't have third-party motor cover.
Right. Mm-hmm. So that's where Supreme Court and IRDA has come over. And I believe it's really a welcome step from even the customer's point of view that, when they buy something which is compulsory upfront, when you're buying a vehicle and you just get your insurance for 3 years or 5 years, you're just off your head, off your responsibility to see whether, you're sufficiently covered. There's a flip side to this as well, because since you're buying upfront and we being intermediaries, what I feel is the market is getting prejudiced in the sense, as far as the intermediation is concerned, the first time when you buy your insurance, it is normally through dealers.
Mm.
So this policy, this products are completely, the way they are structured currently, there are not much standalone policies for own damage cover.
Mm.
So what will happen is typically, the premium will get, you know, the way the premium will go, it will go to one insurance company or one intermediary locked in for 3 years, and not enough of competitors will get a chance to have this market share.
That's a very important point, for both from the point of view of insurers and intermediaries, but also customers. We as customers will not have the right to change. If we don't like our insurer, you can't change it next year. This week, we are discussing the all-important Supreme Court order, which makes it mandatory for all new cars to have a third-party motor insurance cover for 3 years, and for bikes, now this has been extended to 5 years. So the question is, will you have to buy this policy up front? What are the products you can expect in this market? And that's exactly what we're discussing with our panel of experts. Puneet, let me come to you. What should a customer expect from the 1st of September? Because I believe right now premium rates are also not very clear, because for motor third party, the premiums are decided by the regulator, right?
Yeah. So there is a bit of confusion around that. I mean, as insurers, we are looking at, I mean, since you said that the third-party premiums are regulated, and we are expecting to hear on that from the regulator, in the sense that are they going to be 3x or 5x, or are they going to allow something on investment income for 3 years or expense saving for 3 years versus the opportunity lost for an annual increase that happens in April every year? I mean, those adjustments, or it's simply going to be 3x or 5x? So that's something that is awaited from the regulator on the TP side. From the customer side, I think there is one more confusion, that a customer who is looking to really buy a comprehensive cover which covers the vehicle and the third-party liability, there is no solution that is coming up. So I think there also the expectation from the regulator is that they come up with, you know, guidelines around how, you know, they perceive the full comprehensive covers for 3 years and 5 years. And I mean, looking at the time frame of, you know, less than 10 days left for this being rolled out, I think initially it is going to be a bit of chaos, in the sense that there is not enough clarity, there is not enough time with insurers to actually set up their systems. Even if the regulator comes up with a 3x or a 5x TP premium, the IT systems have to be worked upon, and stuff like that has to be, you know, really worked upon. And since, as our colleague Rakesh said, that this is being sold across length and breadth of the country, the information dissemination is also not that very fast going to happen. So that is also going to take some time, because people are used to one set of rates. The communication also has to be, you know, tightened up to, so that everybody knows what is to be charged. And ultimately, I could see, you know, cars not getting registered because of this not getting implemented.
That would that's an important point. And that's not something that will obviously go down very well with the auto industry. They'll also be extremely concerned about what happens if bookings start getting sort of halted till there's clarity on this extremely important subject. Rakesh, let me bring you in on this, since a lot of this is still work in progress and within the realm of discussion. From an insurer's standpoint, I have a two-part question. First of all, will bundled policies no longer make sense, comprehensive insurance, because there is your own damage and that you can continue to buy for 1 year or multiple years, it's your choice. But then there is third party, which the court has now said it has to be 3 years for cars and 5 years for bikes or two-wheelers. So then will we see more unbundled products? And what will that mean for the customer and for you?
See, Surbhi, I think what we need to really see, that in the past when one-year policies were given, I think the car was looked like a single product, and two separate type of covers and own damage and a third party were put together. Frankly, the nature of the risk for both the products are very different. So if somebody has to split that, I think it is also quite logical. So structurally speaking, mandatory insurance will follow the law of the land, and I think we need to stay with that, because it is not something which a customer can, you know, disagree with. When it comes to, you know, customer choices and preferences, I guess whether a person wants to have even a one-month product, why even a one-year, or maybe a three-year or a five-year, these are like, you know, the way you decide what is convenient for me, what am I willing to pay for it. And I think to that extent, both bundling as well as unbundling will keep on happening, looking at customer preferences, customer segments and all. So I don't think there is any particular solution. I think it's a good idea for us to free up these products. And as long as people buy insurance willingly in the way they want, I think it should be encouraged. Surbhi, I just wanted to add a point which might be helpful for a lot of you to understand. See, today, while we have said only 2 out of 3 vehicles are not covered, I think if you look at the categories, the private car categories, even up to 3 years, almost 80-85% remain insured. When it comes to two-wheeler, there is a dramatic fall in the insurance. So one of the points which are getting discussed and debated is, even if you were to mandate a 3-year TP policy for four-wheelers or private cars, that will not dramatically improve the penetration of insurance. And you may ask a customer to upfront pay for the 3 years on a sizable amount of money. Whereas the more important thing is on the two-wheelers, wherein almost 80-90% fall off insurance within 1 to 3 years. So in some sense, the penetration of insurance is a bigger need in two-wheelers. And perhaps to start with, the two-wheelers is a good segment to go for. And if that is addressed meaningfully, the experience can be extrapolated over other lines.
Okay, fair enough. Rakesh, one more point before we let you go. How best do you think the premiums can be handled? Because if the mandate is straight away upfront payment, 3 years or 5 years, that, as you said, it will increase the cost and, maybe it will put a lot of burden. So I don't know, for instance, how, large cab aggregators, big fleet operators, I mean, how they would look at, something like this. So people with, multiple vehicles, etc. So is there a case to maybe consider some sort of staggered payout? Does that even make sense to you?
See, Surbhi, I think staggered payout, while industry gets sometimes an installment policies, but in this case, the installment will actually defeat the objective because, people cannot pay the installment and hence remain uninsured. And that is precisely what the court is trying to address. The only saving grace, what I see, is that almost 85 to 90% of the vehicles today are getting financed. And I think it would make sense now to include the cost of insurance in the cost of, the vehicle finance. And maybe for the customer, it becomes an EMI. And for the insurance company, it becomes like an upfront payment. So this looks to be a logical outcome to me. And on one of the other points, Surbhi, I just thought for the benefit of viewers and yourselves, one of the big challenges for the industry is that the awards which are generally being given on third-party liabilities, the basis of computing the awards also keeps on, improving or changing from time to time. So one of the things as an industry we will always be concerned with is today when I am pricing a product, I am looking at the current way of calculating a claim award. But tomorrow, after a year, suppose, if the claim award or the basis changes and the amount which has to be paid out improves or increases to the claimant, then the premium which we have decided, in the past will become significantly inadequate. And that can severely impact the industry, in terms of its solvency, in terms of its profitability. Something of these lines we have seen in the past when we had a motor pool for, the third-party liability, wherein the industry took a huge hit and even the solvency had to be relaxed by IRDA for the industry to overcome that pool impact. So I think somewhere there are lots of complicated issues which has to be forecasted before the pricing is worked.
Sure. Puneet, I just quickly want to bring you in on this on 30 seconds on the point that Rakesh, raised on the impact on insurers, because the counter view that one also gets is that now since there will be so much of upfront premium collection and generally speaking penetration should be better off, then shouldn't eventually premium rates be lower? Because there is, a lot more premium that's getting collected and more people are coming into the, the motor insurance net.
So I think I'll agree with Rakesh on that the court awards for third party liability, they are actually becoming efficient over every year, every judgment, I would like to say. And this impacts the entire outstanding claims at the insurers with the same premium that is there, that we have charged. So with a 3-year or a 5-year lock-in, I cannot recover an additional premium to the from the customer because of increase in awards and the annual increase in the premium by the regulator. So this is going to definitely impact in that sense that my claims outgo or my premium that I have collected might not be sufficient to really handle the claims that may come out of it.
Okay. Gentlemen, as we're coming down to, you know, final thoughts, I want to go back to the very important point that Divya raised, because at the end of it all and at the center of it all is the consumer. And one thing that really makes you wonder is that once you are locked in for 3 years or 5 years, where is the flexibility for me to change my policy? And even if it's a comprehensive cover, then, I mean, at least compare rates, look at if some other insurance company is offering a better deal or some kind of a, you know, special add-on. So all that completely goes away, Rakesh. So that's a little unfair to the customer, isn't it?
I guess that's the cost of driving a vehicle on the roads. So, you know, to some extent, I don't disagree that this is going to be a change from what the customers are used to. But maybe as a matter of, you know, suggestion, maybe portability of policies from one insurance company to another insurance company could perhaps be, you know, introduced at least for third party, which is the standard product with a standard price.
Divya, you've been hearing the product manufacturers. Yes. There are a lot of questions, I think, a lot of you know, sort of unanswered areas right now. How do you expect this to play out? And if you were to make your suggestions as an intermediary, then how do you think this can be rolled out in an efficient and a little more just manner so that the point of flexibility to the customer, end customer, that can also be kept in mind?
Yeah, so to me, as pointed out by the other speakers, you know, the cost of buying insurance is going to be a challenge for the customers, because you know why there is no penetration. If you need to answer that question, the root cause of that is the finance. And as rightly said, if the insurance portion becomes the part of the finance, then I think the long term will not impact if it is charged to them in EMI manner. So my suggestion is, if it is implemented in phased manner, and two-wheelers are the one which are more impacted and more accident-prone, I think if the implementation starts with two-wheeler, the finance two-wheelers, that's where we are addressing what is needed to be.
Okay. Puneet, let me take your thoughts on this as well. Any final, perhaps, suggestions or recommendations that you'd like to make to also the regulator as this is rolled out and implemented?
I think there is one thing that the regulator needs to, you know, really come up with is on the guidelines regarding the comprehensive piece, because the customers, what we have generally seen is customers in 1, 2, and 3 years definitely prefer the coverage for their own vehicle, own damage, which currently in the current situation does not seem like happening, and it definitely would take some time because there are some standard rules which need to be, you know, really drafted around the no-claim bonus, the treatment of no-claim bonus, because you're entering today and exiting at 3 or 5 years. So there is no change in, there is no recovery or payment of no-claim bonus back to the insurer. And on the value of the vehicle, because it is today fixed for 1 year. So you'll have to fix it for 3 years or 5 years respectively. Again, the issues being raised, you know, in the discussion is around the customer not having a choice to move out. So I think there are some flexible rules around cancellation of the policy that would be required. But yes, definitely the third party portion should not be allowed to be cancelled, because otherwise it defeats the entire purpose.
Take your point on board.
These things which, you know, if standardized can, you know, really,
Puneet, take your point absolutely, and specifically the point on no-claim bonus. That's the first thing I ask every time when I'm going in for a renewal, whether I've been given that bonus or not. But thank you very much, gentlemen, for being with us. And thank you, ma'am, also for joining in. I think this is an ongoing subject, ongoing debate. Let's see. Hopefully, we'll have more clarity by the 1st of September. That's it on this week's edition of Money, Money, Money. Thank you for watching.
Thank you.